Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Ever since my years playing in the Auckland Philharmonia, I remember one of the highlights of working there was playing a premiere of a work by Lyell Cresswell, and his music has really struck a chord with me. I think he's colourful, he's imaginative, he's always got something quite special to say, and this piece is no exception. It's called a concerto for orchestra. What that means is we've got like 35 soloists here, and they all get their turn, and they all groove away together, doing awesome rhythms, and sometimes it sounds like they're fighting. because the rhythms are so crossing each other and so intertwined and bouncing off at very fast tempos, so that the resulting I don't really want to use the word chaos, but the resulting impression is of virtuosity and a great sense of communication between all the players. So it's in 8 movements, and they each have a particular challenge. I mean, there's quite a few of them that the challenge is speed, and then the other ones, there's this kind of charm going on in the middle movements, which I'm sure you will appreciate. It's a welcome respite from the energy. So he's a master of I would say that he's a master of energy, and a really amazing sense of rhythms. And this music's interesting because as we work on it, I sometimes have been thinking this is kind of classical music almost getting to jazz, but in a very different way than you would expect. But when you're hearing some of the solos coming through, the clarinet solo, the trumpets and the little bits, it's quite interesting to see how he's kind of making a little bit of a link there. Some of the rhythms are very much identical to what you'll hear jazz big bands playing. But then he might layer it up with some other stuff, so it's that is sometimes hidden, sometimes it's really clear. But it's fascinating to study the score, and I think we can all agree it's quite hard, isn't it? So it's a virtuoso chamber orchestra chamber concerto for chamber orchestra. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.